Janet Blair, an accomplished actress, left an indelible mark on the film and television industry. Born Martha Janet Eggers on April 23, 1921, in Albuquerque, New Mexico, Blair's career spanned over four decades, during which she captivated audiences with her versatile performances and radiant screen presence. After signing a contract with Columbia Pictures in 1941, Blair quickly rose to fame, appearing in numerous films such as I Wake Up Screaming, Tales of Manhattan, and The Razor's Edge. Her talent for both dramatic and comedic roles showcased her range as an actress and solidified her status as a Hollywood star. Throughout her career, Blair graced the small screen as well, with appearances in various television shows, including The Love Boat, Fantasy Island, and Murder, She Wrote. She also starred in the popular television series My Sister Eileen, which earned her critical acclaim and a loyal fan base. Blair's contributions to the entertainment industry extend beyond her on-screen roles. She was also known for her philanthropy and dedication to various charitable causes. Her warm personality and generosity endeared her to many, both on and off the screen. Janet Blair's legacy continues to resonate with audiences today, as her work remains a testament to her enduring talent and impact on the industry. Her life and career serve as an inspiration to aspiring actors and a reminder of the power of perseverance and dedication. Janet Blair was a talented actress who starred in numerous films during the 1940s and 1950s. She was born Laura Janet Blair on April 23, 1921, in Altoona, Pennsylvania. Blair began her career as a singer and dancer before transitioning to acting. She appeared in several popular films, including My Sister Eileen, I Love Trouble, and Baton Rouge. Do you have any interesting facts or stories about Janet Blair that most people don't know? Perhaps you had the opportunity to meet her or see her perform live. We would love to hear about it in the comments below. What sets Janet Blair apart from her contemporaries is her unique blend of talent, beauty, and charisma. She had a warm and approachable screen presence that made her relatable to audiences. Her performances were nuanced and authentic, and she had a remarkable ability to convey emotion through her facial expressions and body language. Do you agree that Janet Blair stood out from her contemporaries? What do you think made her so special? Let us know in the comments below. We have many fascinating stories and anecdotes about Janet Blair coming up, including some funny, shocking, and sad facts. So, keep watching this video to learn more about this classic star. Finally, we would love to hear about your most cherished memory or personal experience related to Janet Blair. Share your stories and memories with us in the comments below. Janet Blair, born Martha Janet Lafferty in 1921, was raised in a family that appreciated performing arts. Her mother, Elizabeth, was a vaudeville actress, and her father, James, was a bandleader. This early exposure to entertainment shaped Blair's interest in acting. As a child, she often accompanied her mother to rehearsals and performances, which fueled her passion for the craft. Blair's path to acting was influenced by her high school drama teacher, Nellie Wagoner. Wagoner recognized Blair's talent and encouraged her to pursue a career in acting. After graduating from high school, Blair moved to New York City to study drama at the American Academy of Dramatic Arts. During her time at the Academy, Blair was taught and mentored by renowned acting coach, Marlon Brando. Brando's approach to acting, which emphasized naturalism and emotional truth, had a significant impact on Blair's development as an actress. She once said in an interview, "Marlon taught me to be real, to connect with my emotions, and to let go of any inhibitions." Blair's early career was marked by appearances in Broadway productions and radio shows. Her breakthrough role came in 1941 when she was cast in the musical comedy Higher and Higher. The success of the play led to a contract with Columbia Pictures, and Blair moved to Hollywood to pursue a career in film. Throughout her career, Blair continued to be influenced by her mentors and peers. She credited her success to the support and guidance she received from her family, teachers, and colleagues. Blair's ability to connect with her audience and deliver compelling performances was a testament to the early influences and mentors who inspired her path. Janet Blair, born Martha Janet Lafferty on April 22, 1921, in Altoona, Pennsylvania, was an American actress. Her father, James Lafferty, was a railroad conductor, and her mother, Bertha, was a homemaker. Blair's family moved to California when she was a child, and she grew up in the San Francisco Bay Area. Blair's interest in performing began at a young age. She started taking dance lessons when she was 5 years old and continued to study dance throughout her childhood. After graduating from high school, Blair worked as a model and appeared in local theater productions. In the early 1940s, Blair was discovered by a talent scout and signed a contract with Columbia Pictures. She made her film debut in the 1943 musical Something to Shout About. Over the next decade, Blair appeared in numerous films, including Tonight and Every Night, The Fuller Brush Man, and Angel on the Amazon. Blair's career was interrupted in the early 1950s when she became ill with rheumatic fever. She spent several months in the hospital and underwent treatment for the illness. After recovering, Blair returned to acting and appeared in several television shows and movies. Throughout her career, Blair was known for her beauty, talent, and versatility. She was a popular leading lady in the 1940s and 1950s and appeared in a wide range of film genres, including musicals, comedies, and dramas. Blair's career spanned several decades, and she continued to act in films and television shows until the 1980s. Blair passed away on February 19, 2007, at the age of 85. She is remembered for her contributions to the world of entertainment and her enduring legacy as a talented actress. Janet Blair's passion for acting was ignited during her childhood in a humble Pennsylvania household. As a young girl, she was enthralled by the performances she saw on the big screen and dreamt of becoming an actress. Her mother, a former chorus girl, nurtured Janet's dreams and encouraged her to pursue her passion. At the age of 14, Janet's life took a dramatic turn when she won a talent contest, which led to her first professional singing engagement at a local theater. This experience solidified her desire to perform and be on stage. She later moved to New York City to study drama and dance, where she was discovered by a talent scout and signed to a movie contract. Janet's big break came in 1941 when she was cast in the film The Touchdown Cat, which was a huge success. From there, she went on to star in numerous films throughout the 1940s and 1950s, including I Love Trouble, My Sister Eileen, and The Fuller Brush Girl. Despite facing many challenges in the male-dominated film industry, Janet's passion for acting never wavered. She continued to work in television and theater, earning critical acclaim for her performances. Her enduring legacy as a talented actress is a testament to her unwavering dedication and passion for her craft. Janet Blair, an accomplished actress, chose the surname Blair in honor of her birthplace, Altoona, located in Blair County, Pennsylvania. She demonstrated remarkable dedication and consistency in her role as Nellie Forbush in the musical South Pacific, performing over 1,200 times over a 3-year period without missing a single performance. Blair was also known for her political views, being a lifelong Republican and a strong supporter of Ronald Reagan. Her commitment to her beliefs and her profession is a testament to her character and work ethic. Janet Blair, born Martha Janet Alois Lafferty, faced several challenges on her journey to becoming a successful actress. Despite her natural talent and passion for performing, she encountered financial struggles and industry skepticism early in her career. Born in 1921, Blair grew up in a low-income family in Altoona, Pennsylvania. Her dream of becoming an actress seemed unattainable due to their financial constraints. However, she remained determined and found creative solutions to overcome these hurdles. At the age of 16, she won a beauty contest, which provided her with a scholarship to study drama and dance at the prestigious Fijian School of Drama and Radio in New York City. Once in New York, Blair faced skepticism from industry professionals who doubted her abilities due to her lack of experience and connections. Undeterred, she continued to hone her craft, taking on various roles in local theater productions and radio shows. Her hard work and dedication paid off when she was discovered by a talent scout and offered a contract with Columbia Pictures in 1941. Throughout her career, Blair faced numerous obstacles, including being miscast in certain roles and dealing with the pressures of Hollywood. Nevertheless, she remained resilient and adaptable, always finding ways to grow as an actress and prove her worth in the industry. Blair's story is a testament to the power of determination, hard work, and resilience. Her ability to overcome financial struggles and industry skepticism serves as an inspiration for aspiring actors and actresses everywhere. Despite the challenges she faced, Janet Blair left an indelible mark on the world of entertainment and will always be remembered for her talent and perseverance. In 1944, Janet Blair attempted to invalidate her 7-year contract with Columbia, claiming that her agent, Alex Holden, had a secret agreement with the studio to receive payment for persuading her to sign. However, the court ruled in favor of Columbia, stating that the contract was beneficial to Blair. One of Blair's notable roles was in the film Once Upon a Time, where she stepped in to replace Rita Hayworth as Jeannie Thompson after Hayworth refused the part. Janet Blair had 2 children, Amanda Mayo, born in 1959, and Andrew Mayo, born in 1961. Janet Blair's career had several breakthrough moments that highlighted her talent and versatility as an actress. In 1941, she was discovered by a talent scout while performing in a New York stage production, which led to her contract with Columbia Pictures. This marked the beginning of her film career, with notable roles in Tales of Manhattan and I Love a Mystery. One of Blair's most significant breakthroughs came with her performance in the 1944 musical Cover Girl, where she starred alongside Rita Hayworth and Gene Kelly. Blair's rendition of Who's Complaining became a hit and showcased her singing and dancing abilities. Critics and audiences alike praised her performance, with the New York Times noting her sparkling presence and bubbly personality. In 1948, Blair starred in the film noir The Lady from Shanghai, directed by Orson Welles. Although her role was relatively small, it was pivotal in establishing her as a serious actress. Her performance was noted for its depth and complexity, with critics praising her ability to hold her own against well-known actors like Welles and Rita Hayworth. Throughout her career, Blair continued to challenge herself with diverse roles, including comedic and dramatic parts. In the 1950s, she transitioned to television, appearing in numerous shows and earning a loyal following. Her work in television, including her role in the popular series Wagon Train, further solidified her status as a talented and versatile actress. Blair's breakthrough moments were marked by her ability to adapt to different genres and roles, showcasing her range and talent. Her contributions to the entertainment industry continue to be celebrated and remembered, with her legacy inspiring future generations of actors and actresses. Janet Blair, an American actress, is well known for her iconic roles in films from the 1940s and 1950s. One of her most memorable roles was in the 1944 musical Bathing Beauty, where she played the character of Caroline Brooks. A notable scene is when she sings the song I'll Walk Alone with a touching and emotional performance. In the 1947 film My Sister Eileen, Blair portrayed Ruth Sherwood, a young woman trying to make it as a writer in New York City. A standout moment is when she comically navigates a chaotic apartment and delivers the line, I can't even hear myself think. Blair also starred in the 1950 film Three Little Words, playing the role of Jessie Brown, a woman who becomes a vaudeville performer. A scene that resonates is when she sings I Want to Be Loved by You alongside Fred Astaire and Red Skelton. These performances, among others, have solidified Janet Blair's place in classic Hollywood history. Her characters and roles continue to be celebrated and remembered for their charm, wit, and memorable scenes. Janet Blair, the actress, was known for her unique approach to her work. She had a natural ability to convey emotions and connect with her audience, making her performances truly memorable. Blair's artistic process was deeply personal and intuitive, often drawing from her own experiences to bring depth and authenticity to her characters. She once mentioned in an interview that she would spend hours alone, rehearsing her lines and exploring the inner world of her characters. This allowed her to fully embody each role and create a unique style that set her apart from her peers. Blair's approach to acting was not about simply reciting lines or following a director's instructions. It was about truly understanding and becoming the character she was portraying. One of the things that made Blair's style so unique was her ability to adapt to different roles and genres. Whether she was playing a comedic character or a dramatic lead, Blair always brought a sense of authenticity and depth to her performances. This versatility was a testament to her talent and dedication as an actress. Blair's personal experiences and worldview were also reflected in her work. She was known for choosing roles that challenged societal norms and stereotypes, and she was not afraid to take on controversial or unconventional characters. This fearlessness and commitment to her craft earned her the respect and admiration of her peers and audiences alike. In conclusion, Janet Blair's artistic vision and process were truly unique and remarkable. Her ability to connect with her audience, adapt to different roles and genres, and reflect her personal experiences and worldview in her work set her apart from her peers and made her a truly exceptional actress. Janet Blair's singing talents with Hal Kemp's band at the Coconut Grove in Los Angeles in 1941 caught the eye of a Columbia Pictures talent scout, leading to her contract with the studio. Despite the size of her roles, Blair received star billing in her hometown of Altoona, Pennsylvania when her films were screened, reflecting her local popularity. Janet Blair was a significant figure in the golden age of Hollywood, known for her lively spirit and versatility. She began her career in the late 1930s and quickly became a popular leading lady in musicals and comedies. One of Blair's most notable contributions to the industry was her ability to seamlessly blend singing and acting. She starred in several successful musical films, including My Sister Eileen and Thanks for the Memory. Her performances were praised for their energy and charm, and she was often compared to other great musical actresses of the time, such as Judy Garland and Betty Hutton. Blair's influence can also be seen in the trends and techniques of later actresses. Her natural and relatable style of acting was a departure from the more exaggerated performances of the past, and it paved the way for a more subtle and realistic approach to acting in film and television. According to film historian G9 Basinger, Janet Blair was a breath of fresh air in Hollywood. She brought a modern sensibility to her roles, and her performances were always grounded in reality. She was a true original, and her influence can still be seen today. Blair's impact on the industry is also evident in the many actors and filmmakers she inspired. Actress and singer Kristen Chenoweth has cited Blair as one of her inspirations, saying, "Janet Blair was the whole package. She could sing, dance, and act with the best of them. She was a true triple threat, and I've always admired her talent and grace." In conclusion, Janet Blair was a trailblazing actress who made significant contributions to the film industry. Her ability to blend singing and acting, her natural and relatable style, and her influence on later actors and filmmakers have left an indelible mark on Hollywood. Janet Blair's career was marked by both success and personal tragedy. In 1952, while she was at the height of her fame, Blair suffered a devastating loss. Her husband, John Cotton, died unexpectedly at the age of 37, leaving Blair a young widow with a daughter to raise. The couple had been married for only 4 years. This tragic event had a profound impact on Blair, and she never remarried. She continued to act in films and on television, but the lightness and joy that had once characterized her performances were often overshadowed by a sense of sadness and loss. Despite the challenges she faced, Blair remained a respected and beloved figure in Hollywood, and her contributions to the world of entertainment continue to be remembered and celebrated today. Janet Blair, the talented actress, led a life full of passion and values that extended beyond the silver screen. She was known for her love of animals and often took in stray cats and dogs, providing them with a loving home. This compassion for animals was reflected in her work, as she often chose roles that allowed her to highlight the importance of treating all creatures with kindness and respect. Blair was also deeply committed to her family and valued the time she spent with them above all else. She was a devoted wife and mother and often spoke about the joy that her family brought into her life. This love for her family was evident in her performances, as she brought a warmth and sincerity to every role she played. In addition to her love of animals and family, Blair was also passionate about giving back to her community. She was involved in numerous charitable organizations throughout her life, using her platform to make a positive impact on those around her. One cause that was particularly close to her heart was the fight against cancer. She was a vocal advocate for cancer research and participated in numerous fundraising events to support the cause. Blair's personal values and interests were a driving force behind her work, and she often chose roles that allowed her to explore these passions. Whether she was playing a devoted mother, a loving wife, or a compassionate animal advocate, Blair brought a depth and authenticity to every performance that resonated with audiences. Her legacy as an actress and a humanitarian continues to inspire and impact those who knew her and those who have seen her work. If you're a fan of classic Hollywood, you won't want to miss out on the work of Janet Blair, an actress who graced the silver screen with her talent and charm. From her early days as a radio singer to her successful film career, Blair left an indelible mark on the entertainment industry. Throughout her career, Blair appeared in a variety of film genres, from musicals to film noir, showcasing her versatility and range as an actress. Some of her most memorable roles include Irene in My Sister Eileen and Billy Smith in The Big Street. But Blair's contributions to the entertainment industry didn't stop at film. She also had a successful career on television, appearing in numerous shows throughout the 1950s and 1960s. Now, we want to hear from you. What are your thoughts on Janet Blair's work and legacy? Share your memories and favorite roles in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this content, be sure to like and share it with your friends. We're passionate about celebrating the creative spirits who have shaped entertainment, and we couldn't do it without your support. So, if you're not already subscribed, be sure to hit that button to stay up to date on all things entertainment. Together, let's continue to honor the legacies of the talented individuals who have left their mark on the entertainment industry.